Let's face it, towing can be stressful, especially if you're new to it or to the latest technology. But you're in luck because you're watching Towing Tips, Tools, and Tech, a Ford live stream event. Whether you're gearing up for a cross-country adventure or hauling a boat to the lake, Ford is here to empower towers of every skill level. So, get your notepad ready and follow along with our Ford engineers. It's time for the show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. This is our special live stream event on towing tips, tools, and tech. And I am your host, Anne. Now, we also have our special guest, a Ford subject matter expert here with us. Everyone, this is Chelsea. And Chelsea, thank you so much for being here with us today.
Yes, always.
All right. Now, folks, first of all, congratulations on your Ford truck. Now, whether this is your very first Ford truck or your 10th Ford truck, we are happy to have you with us here in the Ford family. Now, you may be joining us in a couple of different ways today. We are broadcasting on both Ford.com and on YouTube. So our live stream is going out on a couple of different channels here. Whichever one you're on, we're happy to have you with us. But there is a little bit of a benefit to being with us on Ford.com, and that is it's going to be a little bit more interactive for those of you who are with us through Ford's own website. And that's because you can log into the chat box and send us your questions. Now, we're going to be covering a lot of topics, but we know that we can't cover absolutely everything. So if you have questions that pop to mind, all you have to do is log into that chat box, type them in there, and we have a fantastic team of moderators in the back waiting to answer those questions for you. And who knows, you may even get your question answered live here on air. So please do not hesitate to send us those questions. Now, we would also ask that you share this link with your friends, your fellow Ford pickup owners. We want to help as many of you as possible, whether you are new to towing or whether you are an advanced, basically an expert at towing. We've got some great information for all groups today, and we want to make sure that we're helping as many of you as possible. Now, we will also let you know that at the end of our broadcast today, we are going to give you an opportunity to give us feedback. So if there are future topics that you'd like us to cover, other vehicles, let us know what you thought. We would absolutely love to hear that feedback from you. All right, so I also want to let you know that we are going to cut away to some live stream footage, basically, previously filmed footage that we did out on a ranch, out on the road. We wanted to show you these trucks in action, and obviously we have a beautiful studio here. We can do a lot of things, but we can't quite show you the trucks out on the road. So we will cut away to some other footage a couple of times here through the broadcast just to show you what these trucks are really capable of. Now, our show tonight is going to be made up of two main components. We're going to start with Chelsea and I covering the basics of towing. So if you are new to towing, this is going to be how to tow a trailer for the first time, the essentials of getting set up, all of those little things you need to know before you get on the road and tow for the first time. Then a little later in the show, we are going to move into what our advanced towers might want to learn, especially some of the technology advancements that are available on some of our vehicles. So if you have one of those vehicles with some advanced towing technologies, that later segment of the show is going to be for you. All right, so here's how it's really going to go. We will start with our beginner section. We're going to start with things you need to know before you tow. Then we will go into hooking up the trailer, taking it out on the road, and then finish up with backing up and parking the trailer. Then we'll move to our other studio, to Errol and Bobby, and they're going to go into some advanced coverage. So they're going to again start with things you need to know before you tow, but at an advanced level. They'll go through hitch prep, in-vehicle trailer setup, hooking up the trailer, and advanced features for backing up a trailer. So, folks, it's a lot of great stuff that we're going to cover for you in this live stream. So, Chelsea, you think you're ready to go?
Yeah, let's do this.
All right, great. Let's drive right into the essentials of towing here. So, we were able to go out to the ranch. You were able to show me a lot of this stuff, but go ahead and get me started here. What are the things I really need to know before I get on the road?
Yeah, before we get on the road, I think it's best to go over some basic yet important numbers that when it comes to your truck and your trailer to see if you can even tow what you want to tow before you go.
Oh, yeah, so, that's a big question for people, right?
Yeah, it's okay. Probably the number one question. So a tool that I like to use often is the trailer towing capability calculator.
Right.
And that can be found online in the Ford RV and Trailer Tow Guide.
Okay.
And I think ahead of time, I kind of pre-calculated for you, and we have it set up, filled out to what we have matched here in the studio.
Yep, and I've got that. I'll follow along as you talk me through it.
Yeah, so step one is just going to be all about what's in our trailer. And the nice thing about this calculator is it's going to do most of the work for us. Mm-hmm. We just got to put in a few inputs where prompted. And the first one is going to be about our trailer. So you may have heard the term dry weight, and that just means how your trailer usually is going to come from the factory. Nothing in it, on it, completely unloaded.
Okay.
So that's going to be input one. Input two is going to be all the weight that you're going to add to your trailer. So in this case, we have a nice ATV. That's going to be that weight. So if you want to read those numbers out for what we have in the studio.
It looks like our dry weight is going to be 830 pounds. And then our content weight is also 830 pounds, so that makes it easy to remember. So then our total trailer weight, I'm going to have to do math here, is 1,660 pounds, right?
Yep, that's right, and the calculator will do that for you.
Okay, and then I'm also looking at our particular kind of trailer that we have here, and I remember you talking about this. We have a conventional hitch, right?
Yep, that's correct. It's going to ask you to check what kind of hitch you have, and here in the studio we have a conventional hitch. So step two in the calculator is all going to be about the payload.
And that's what goes in the bed of the truck?
No, that's actually a common misconception. Payload is going to be anything you add to your vehicle. So passengers, your camping gear, any extra cargo. If you bring your dog along, he's going to be part of your payload.
So Ruffles and I are part of the payload?
Yes, that's right.
Okay, well that's good to know. All right.
So we're going to want to know this payload of what we add, but we're going to want to compare it to our max payload rating. And we can actually find that in the door jamb. So
oh, really?
Let's go take a look and see if we can find it. So, yep, right here on this sticker, it is rated to 1,238 pounds. So we're never going to want to exceed that number with whatever we add to our vehicle.
Okay, that's good to know. And we can always find that sticker right there.
Yes.
Okay, excellent.
So pre-calculated numbers that we have already, what do we kind of have for what's in the studio?
All right. We have our max payload rating of 1,238 pounds. And our payload is 550 pounds.
Yep, so based on that, we're good on this step. We do not exceed that max rating.
All right, great.
So step three is gonna come to our gross vehicle weight rating.
Okay.
And that also can be found on a sticker here on this one. So it looks like here our Maverick in studio is rated to 5,205 pounds.
All right, and then we also need to know our
gross vehicle weight.
Okay.
So that's going to be what our payload was plus the weight of the vehicle, and that number is there in the sheet.
That looks like it's 4,517 pounds.
Perfect. That's under the 5,000 pounds, so we're good on this step as well.
Okay, fabulous. So we're all good on that. So let's head on back here and start kind of doing the big numbers at the end, right?
Yeah, so our last number in step four is going to be your gross combined vehicle weight rating.
Okay.
And that is going to be your total weight of your truck, your trailer, everything combined that your vehicle can safely handle.
Okay.
So that number, you'll have to find that in the Ford RV and Trailer Towing Guide. Okay. And I think we looked it up.
So our rating is 8,145 pounds, but our total was 6,011 pounds.
Yep, so that checks as well. We don't exceed the max.
All right.
And that means we're good to tow.
Now we also have a tow rating on here, and that's gonna be something slightly different again, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what I'm seeing is we can always find that in the RV and trailer guide,
that's
right?
Your number one resource.
Okay, so what is ours here?
So that's just gonna be your gross combined weight rating minus your vehicle weight. So then that's going to be, the difference is going to be what you're able to tow.
Okay, so ours, it looks like the Maverick can tow up to 4,000 pounds.
Yep, because we have the conventional hitch with the max tow package, and that allows it to do 4,000 pounds.
Okay, but obviously that varies by vehicle,
yes,
and you always
course.
Kind of want to know what your particular rating is.
Yep, and you can always reference that towing guide online, ford.com/towing.
All right, fabulous. I think I get all of that. Now, I'm also looking, we talked a little bit about this being a conventional hitch, but I see a lot of options over here.
Yes. So okay. There are, one of the first things that I learned when I started towing, it's not a one size fits all when it comes to your hitch receiver, and your hitch ball sizes. So here you can see we have a solid and a hollow hitch.
Okay.
The main difference there is the solid one is going to be rated to hold more load.
Okay.
You can even have an extension here that you see in the back of that one. Yep. So maybe you want your tailgate down with your trailer attached. You can have an extension hitch.
That's brilliant. Okay.
So when it comes to these here, they look to be the same size.
Okay.
Let me show you a little bit closer. So they are in fact the same 2 5/16 inch. But you can see here their diameters on the bottom are quite different.
Okay.
So that's just going to mean the weight that they're rated and capable of towing. So this one, the smaller one, is going to be good for 6,000 pounds.
Okay.
And then this one here for 14,000 pounds.
Oh, so that's way more than we need.
Yes.
Okay, fabulous.
So really when it comes to all this, it's just like one big puzzle. You got to make sure everything fits, and it's all just about meeting your truck and your trailer height so you can tow properly.
Okay, fabulous. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a silly question, so bear with me. Can I tow without a hitch? I mean, I can't, right?
No, actually you can. If you have a Ranger or F-150, it's now designed for bumper towing, and it's just set up so in the step bumper, you can be able to tow without a hitch. So Ranger with this configuration can tow up to 3,500 pounds, and an F-150 up to 5,000 pounds. So that's, again, be that max rating.
Okay, but not the Maverick.
Not
I can't do that with the Maverick.
Correct.
But with a Ranger or an F-150, I could tow without a hitch.
Yep.
Wow, bumper towing, that's wild. Okay. All right, so then the next thing we have to look at is the trailer itself, right? And I remember you saying something about the dimensions. I need to know how big it is?
Yeah, some basic dimensions you're going to want to know are the length and the width. If you have a Ranger, you can set up BLIS with trailer coverage.
Okay, and BLIS is our blind spot information system.
Yeah, those little indicators in your side view mirror that let you know a vehicle is passing.
And it can cover the trailer,
yep,
too.
Yep, covers the trailer.
That's brilliant because it's this extra length and it's hard to tell sometimes, right?
Yeah, some other dimensions you might want to note are going to be your height and your weight if you have an F-Series truck. You'll be able to set up trailer profiles, and I think we'll be getting into that later in the show.
Yeah, I think Errol and Bobby are going to show us a little bit more about that. Okay, so we've got all of that kind of figured out. We have our trailer's GVWR.
Yeah, and that also can usually be found on a sticker, so I think this one here. Yep, so our max cargo should never exceed 2,160 pounds.
Which we're good.
Which
we
confirmed earlier.
830. So,
yes.
Okay, all right, we're good to go there. Now, I'm also looking at how our cargo is set up here, and correct me if I'm wrong, it actually looks like it's kind of forward on the trailer.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
That's correct, and that's intentional. That's how you're going to want to distribute your load when loading your cargo. A basic rule of thumb is the 60-40 rule, where 60% of your weight should be in front of the trailer axle, and then 40% should be behind it. And that's just going to help prevent trailer sway.
Okay, which seems like something we obviously don't want.
Sounds like a scary term, but it's just going to mean when your load is out of balance.
Okay.
And I think they have a video showing you properly and improperly loaded trailers and what can happen.
Yep, with our little model car there. Okay.
Yeah, so we do have trailer sway control, which is going to help mitigate trailer sway before you might even notice it happening.
Okay. So you might not even notice that your trailer's starting to wobble,
yep,
and that system is going to, how is it helping?
Yeah, it's going to apply brakes to the individual wheels and help reduce your engine torque. This is going to aid in vehicle stability.
Okay.
You may, if you do notice it occurring, don't panic. Just kind of slow down to start controlling your vehicle again and pull over as soon as possible in a safe area to readjust that load, remembering that 60-40 rule we discussed.
All right, fabulous. Now, there's a couple other things I'm seeing here on the trailer itself. Our hitches are not part of our weight consideration, right? We wouldn't want these.
No, we kind of would want to remove those before we started towing.
Right, because they're just loose anyway.
Yeah, we wouldn't want them to fly away either. Got to always make sure everything is secure before you take off.
Okay, fabulous. And then I also see some cables back here. Yeah. Now, what are these?
So this is going to be electrical wiring for your trailer, for your lights and whatnot. If you have a flat 4-pin connector, you are not going to have trailer brakes.
Okay.
So you're probably towing something light enough.
Okay. And the truck will be able to do all of the work for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you might also notice a flat 5-pin connector, and that's going to mean your trailer has surge brakes and is not going to need a trailer brake controller.
Okay.
And then if you see a round 7-pin connector, that's going to mean you have an electronic system on your trailer, and it's going to be capable and compatible with our Ford trailer brake controller.
Okay, and we'll look at how we hook that up here in a minute.
Yes.
But I think I get all of that. Obviously, we'd take all of this off partially so we don't lose it, right? Which I think I remember my dad maybe doing that at one point when I was younger. So we don't want to do that. But we actually went out at the ranch, and Chelsea was a wonderful teacher, and she taught me how to line the truck up and get it back to the hitch. We used the rear view camera system, we used dynamic hitch assist, and with some fabulous coaching, I was able to do that. So we've got that footage for you now. So let's go ahead and have a look at that, and we will be back with you in about a minute. All right, Chelsea, I'm completely new at this. What do I need to do?
All right, before we got in, we did check the surrounding area, made sure it was clear. Mm-hmm. We can see our trailer in the back. We also disabled our rear backup sensors. We don't want those going off with our trailer attached. If you want to do that again, you can find that in the cluster. So let's go ahead and start. Let's put it in reverse.
Okay.
Good, so you'll see the camera here pop up on the screen. Very convenient, you'll have the red, yellow, green lines. That kind of gives us a gauge of our distance, how close we are to an object. In this case, our trailer here. You see that dotted line there?
Right here, yeah.
Yeah, that's a dynamic hitch assist. So as you move and kind of turn your steering wheel, it's gonna stay lined up and keep you centered to help you line that ball up to the hitch. Also feel free to use your side view mirrors to help you line it up.
All right, okay, here we go, here's hoping.
Kind of in the green zone, you can see that. Maybe a little to the left, maybe. Perfect.
Hey, all right.
All right. Looks good. Put it in park.
Okay.
Now we're actually going to want to put on the parking brake. Yeah.
Okay.
So that'll keep the vehicle from shifting forward or backwards. So when we get out to lower the hitch, it should be set and stayed in place.
All right.
So let's go give it a check.
Okay. All right. So as you can see, it's really not that hard to get your truck lined up to the hitch, right? Chelsea was obviously very patient, but it actually only took me a couple of practice attempts, and I was able to do that thanks to a great teacher and some great basic helpful systems that are built into the truck. So take advantage of them. They're very much there to help you. All right, now we're all lined up here. So we did this once out there, but go ahead and walk me through actually hooking up our trailer.
So we're gonna first start by lowering our trailer, which means we're gonna have to raise our trailer jack.
Okay.
We're gonna keep raising it.
And we are on a nice smooth surface here in the studio, but we've also got chocks on our tires back there to make sure that our trailer doesn't move. Everything's set up nice and easy for us here in the studio. So make sure you do that when you're out in the real world too.
Yep, so it does look like our trailer is secure on our ball, but I'm gonna keep raising that jack all the way, and that's gonna be for ground clearance when we're out on the road. We're not gonna want anything hitting that, so we're gonna raise it all the way.
All right.
So that's nice and secure.
All right.
Put in our hitch pin. Then we're gonna go with our safety chains. So the main thing here is we're gonna have to remember to cross them. So this one is on this side, and it's gonna have to come up under here.
Okay, and I remember you saying when we were out there that sometimes it helps to twist them, right?
Yeah, so that's gonna help keep them from dangling on the ground when you're driving in the middle of the road. So we're just gonna twist them and tighten them up.
Okay, fabulous.
And we have our electrical wiring. And as discussed earlier, we have a flat 4-pin, but it is on an adapter to a 7-pin. So we can just connect that like this. And it's nice and snug.
Excellent. Okay, so then we're all hooked up here, right?
Yep, we'll remove these blocks. Don't want to run over those.
That
makes
sense.
We're going to need them when we unhitch.
Okay.
Put those in the bed.
All right.
So we're set here, but we're probably going to want to check our trailer lights and brakes. So maybe you go around the back, I'll go up front.
You got it. It's funny, this is where my dad always sent me too. Usually when it was raining, though. All right, so obviously we want to check our trailer lights to make sure that that's all working before we take off.
Yep, so right blinker.
Right blinker's good.
Left blinker.
Left blinker's good.
And how about our brakes?
And the brakes look great.
Awesome, so
okay,
I would probably
fabulous.
Also adjust the mirrors while I'm up here as well, just for the extra trailer length.
Okay, and we have a kind of a checklist that we can go through to make sure we did all of this stuff,
yes.
right? Okay, and then I guess I'm thinking of, you know, with your car, the other things that you always want to check, things like tire pressure and whatnot, do we want to do that with our trailer too?
Yes, of course, and especially if we don't tow as often, we're going to want to check everything out for safety purposes, right? We don't want to be on the side of the road when we could be at our destination, so.
Obviously, that's just time lost in having fun. Okay, so things like your tire pressure, like your lug nuts, make sure we check those as well before we take off.
Yes, all of that.
Okay, fabulous. All right, so up next, we actually were able to go out on the road, and Chelsea was actually good enough to take me out with her. We had a ranger to check out some of the truck's abilities when you are driving. So we were able to look at that BLIS with trailer coverage in action. So we're gonna go ahead and show you that now, and we'll be back with you live in a couple of minutes. All right, Chelsea, so I'm looking at our side mirrors here, and I see what I think is an indicator. Can you tell me about those?
Yeah, Anne, that's correct. Those are the warning indicators for the blind spot information system, or BLIS. It lets us know when a vehicle's in our blind spot.
Oh, okay.
It's also gonna work while we're towing, just like we are right now.
Really? Well, how does it do that?
The sensors, they're located in the tail lamps, and if it detects a vehicle in your blind spot, or up to 33 feet behind your vehicle when towing, the solid light is going to remain on until the vehicle completely passes.
That is so cool.
Now just remember, you have to set up all your basic trailer towing information before you start driving.
Basic trailer information needs to be set up in the system before the BLIS system can be used with it. That's done through the instrument cluster screen. Using the controls on the left side of the steering wheel, in the menu choose Driver Assist, Blind Spot, choose a trailer, confirm the trailer is less than 8.2 feet wide, and confirm the trailer is less than 33 feet long. Enter the trailer length.
All right, so I think I see a vehicle behind us, and I think they're getting ready to pass, so I'm gonna keep an eye. Oh, yep, there, our indicator is already lit up. There they go.
Yeah, and if we had our blinker on in that situation, the solid light would have been flashing instead. So, just a helpful tip.
That is so good to know. Thank you, Chelsea. Hey, Chelsea, what's this button here? The one that looks like a little trailer.
Yeah, this one, this is our tow haul mode. So we use it when we have a load in the bed or we're towing something. It's gonna change the shifting patterns of the transmission so we're in the right gear at the right time to help vehicle performance. So we can just push it here to engage drive mode, and it's gonna show up in our instrument cluster.
Oh, that's really cool. Can we go ahead and give it a try?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right.
Hilly terrain is where the system is especially noticeable and helpful. When we go up this hill, you'll notice how it holds that lower gear longer. It's gonna help us get up and over that hill with the extra weight of the trailer. It also helps control vehicle speed when going downhill. You may feel it downshifting to help control your speed with engine braking.
Chelsea, that was awesome. Thank you so much for the demonstration. But I'm curious, now, when I go to use tow haul mode myself, what should it feel like?
You should still be able to feel the weight of what you're towing, but the range is gonna make it feel like it's not working that hard. That's the true beauty of it. It has the engine and the transmission in that sweet spot when towing in most driving conditions. One thing to remember though, if you stop at some point and turn off the ignition, when you get back in and want to drive again, you'll have to re-engage that tow haul mode.
Good to know. Thank you again so much for everything, Chelsea.
You're welcome.
And of course, if you have any questions or ever need a refresher, you can always refer to the owner's manual.
Will do.
All right, so some great demonstrations of both BLIS with trailer coverage and tow haul mode. And Chelsea, thank you so much for taking me out and showing me how it's done. Now, I have to say that when we were out there, obviously I wasn't driving, but I could still feel a change, I guess, in how everything was working. So can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, you probably most likely noticed the difference in acceleration with the extra weight of the trailer. It kind of reduced our acceleration. So you'll just need to give yourself more time, more space to do things like merge into traffic. And also when it comes to slowing down or coming to a complete stop, you're just gonna wanna give yourself that extra time and space with the extra weight that you have behind you.
So no pulling out in front of people or stopping suddenly in front of them.
Not a good idea.
All right, very good. Now, when we were out at the ranch, you let me do some driving as well, which again, thank you. And I remember you saying that I needed to take wider turns. Can you explain that a little bit too?
Yeah, with the extra length behind you with that trailer, you're gonna wanna make a little bit wider turns, but you're not gonna wanna make too wide of turns. You might start to encounter objects on the outside of your turn, things like fuel pumps. So just finding that right balance.
Obviously, we don't wanna go hitting a fuel pump. So how do I guess, make sure that I'm doing it right?
Yeah, so you're just gonna wanna look further ahead while driving, use those side view mirrors, and then just a lot of practice. It's gonna take time.
All right, so getting into an open area and practicing is always helpful. Good to know. All right, now I would guess, because we've now got weight on behind us, that this is gonna affect our mileage too, right?
Yeah, so there's gonna be a few different things that are gonna factor into your mileage. So one of those is gonna be the frontal area considerations.
Okay, and that would be like if we had a box trailer, right?
Yeah, with a
wall
flat
here.
Surface, yep.
Okay, and we would calculate that by what? Multiplying the width and the height of the front?
Yep.
Okay.
And so all those considerations you'll need to take into account, and you can always reference the Ford RV and Trailer Towing Guide for
of
best
course.
Recommendations on how to calculate that and what you should use with your vehicle.
All right, so just again, like with any other vehicle, aerodynamics and weight, and I would guess how you're driving, those all matter?
Yep,
right?
Of course. So your speed, how well, how fast or slow you're accelerating, braking, weather conditions, even the terrain you're driving on, hilly versus flat, are all gonna have some play and effect with your gas mileage.
Okay, so just keep an eye on your mileage.
Yes.
All right, fabulous. All right, now I've said it a couple of times, how patient and wonderful you were as we were out at the ranch, you letting me drive and actually try things. And folks, here's the big one. Backing up and parking a trailer. I know this is the one that gives us all the most anxiety, but Chelsea walked me through it beautifully, and I think I did fairly well. So you go ahead and check it out in this video, and we will be back with you shortly.
All right, so first we checked our surrounding areas and we saw that we were clear.
Okay.
So let's put it in reverse.
All righty.
Then we're gonna wanna put our hands at the bottom of the steering wheel. So that may seem new and uncomfortable to you, but this is gonna be your steering perspective when you're backing up a trailer. So if you want the trailer to go right, you're gonna take your right hand and steer up from the bottom of the steering wheel. Perfect, just like that. And if you wanna go left, you'll go up from the bottom with your left hand.
Okay.
So we can use our camera here to watch, and we can use our side view mirrors to guide us. So let's give it a shot.
All right, so I'm looking at where my trailer needs to go, and it looks like it needs to go left. Right?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Yep. You just take your time, nice and slow.
Okay.
Looking good.
Okay. And when do I straighten out here?
You can probably start to straighten out right about now.
Yep.
Just about there. And we'll call that good.
All right. Nice job,
Ann.
Fabulous.
Not too bad for your first time.
Thank you.
So one thing you might want to note, shorter trailers, they're going to turn a little bit more quickly than the longer ones.
Mm-hmm.
So you just have to be slower, more patient with them. But the more you practice, the more you'll get the hang of it. And I think you'll be a pro in no time.
Well, thank you so much for all of your help here, Chelsea. It was a wonderful having you here with us again.
You're welcome.
All right, folks, so there you have some fantastic tips for learning to back up a trailer for the first time. Chelsea, again, you were so patient. You were such a good teacher. And of course, through the magic of film, it looks like I got it right away. Now, what you didn't know is that we actually went out. Chelsea taught me a little bit before we filmed that. We went out into just a nice open area and let me figure it out a few times. So as always, practice, right?
Yes,
practice makes perfect. And doing it in an open area where it takes the stress off of you was a great idea. So thank you so much, Chelsea. All right, we're all parked. We've got our trailer where we want it. We're again on a flat surface, and now we need to unhitch it. So we go in reverse order, right?
Pretty much. We're going to do what we did in the reverse order. Because we are in the studio, we never unchalked our trailer tires. So we're going to chalk those up. We're going to make sure to do both sides now, because if we unhitch, it could pivot if we only do one side. So we want to make sure to have both sides chalked up before we start to do any unhitching.
Which is especially important if we're on uneven ground.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So here, we're going to take out our hitch pin.
All righty.
Yep. And then we're going to start to raise our trailer by lowering our jack, our tongue jack.
Everything's a little bit opposite with trailers, isn't it?
Yep.
All right. Fabulous.
And you'll notice I pulled out our blocks from the truck bed ahead of time.
Right.
And that's just going to help distribute the load so we don't leave any indents in the cement and whatnot.
Okay. And you're getting a nice little arm workout with this one. But there are different types of hitches, of course, too, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
All right. We are almost there.
All right. Okay.
And then we're going to undo our safety chains. So we can either put them back on the side that they go, or we can keep them crossed so you always remember to cross them when you attach them. So
All
it's kind of your preference there.
And it looks like this trailer has a nice little place to hook them, but if we didn't have that, we could kind of
we could
send
just
them over?
Throw them over the side.
Okay.
Not let them drag in the mud and dirt if there's any debris underneath.
Okay.
Yep. Lastly, we're going to unhook our electrical wiring.
All right.
And we're going to try and wrap it up and keep it as far off the ground as possible. And we're going to orient it downward just to keep that debris out and away from our electrical connections.
That makes perfect sense, keeping water out of anything electrical. And it looks like you also closed the door over there, too.
Yes.
So, okay, fabulous.
Yep. So now one thing, we have a trailer lock. So if we want to keep our trailer safe while we're away on our adventures, we're just going to lock it up.
And this makes sure that no one can come along and hook up to our trailer while we're gone.
Yep, so now we're secure and we're ready for an adventure.
All right, well, I am very much ready to go an adventure with you. And that means that we are basically through our trailer basics. And now we are ready to head over to some advanced trailering tips with Errol and Bobby. So Errol, take it away.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Errol, and this is Bobby. Bobby, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good.
And we are here with the 2023 Super Duty. And as you can see, we've got it hooked up to our gooseneck trailer. And we're going to get into that a little bit later. But first, Bobby, I definitely want to thank Ann and Chelsea. They did a great job talking about how to get into towing and really some of the beginner information. And you and I, we're going to talk a little bit more about some of the advanced features, right?
Yes.
All right, fantastic. So one of the main things that I want to do is encourage everyone, because no matter whether you're a beginner or you're advanced, you want to know the main thing. Can I tow this, right? Whatever the this might be for you. And so one of the things that you can rely on is some of the information and some of the tools that we have available for you to be able to use to really calculate if you can tow the this, that whatever that might be for you in your individual towing experience, right?
Right.
So Bobby, one of the things that I think that we can talk about in starting to figure out how we can tow this is, of course, our trailer towing capacity calculator.
Yes.
So let's talk a little bit more about that and reiterate what the importance of that is.
So essentially, we have, it's an online pamphlet of our towing capacities, but in it, it gives you the GVW of your vehicle, it gives you the GCW of your...
Wait, Bobby. Now, the acronyms, like, I know what it means,
yes.
But for everybody out there, break those acronyms down so they can understand what those mean.
So, GVWR is Gross Vehicle Weight Rating.
Okay.
So, you have one for your vehicle, which is the max loading you can put on your vehicle, and you have one for your trailer.
Okay.
And GCWR is gross combined weight rating. And that is the rating of your for your vehicle, but it's for the GVW of the vehicle plus the GVW of the trailer added together.
Got it. That makes sense. And it's important that you want to make sure that you're putting in the calculations so that you don't exceed those numbers, right?
That's correct.
And I know, now I've been doing my research and my homework. I believe in the 2022 towing guide, you can find it on page 52 of the towing 2020 guide in the calculator that you need to go ahead and fill out that information.
Yes.
To make sure you're not exceeding those ratings.
Correct.
All right, good. Now, one of the other thing that we had the opportunity to do is that we did a lot of that preliminary work for our Super Duty and our Gooseneck. So we've kind of taken care of all of that before we got started, right?
Right.
Good. All right. So we're ready to go. Now, I know Ann and Chelsea, they had a chance to go through and cover the conventional trailer. And so one of the things that I have here, and tell me what this is again.
So it's an adapter sleeve. We call it a reducer sleeve.
Okay.
Essentially what you do with it is if with the Super Duty, you have two hitch sizes. You have a 25-inch receiver size, mm-hmm. and you have a 3-inch receiver size.
Okay.
If you have a 3-inch and your shank bar of your your towing drawbar is 2.5, mm-hmm. you can use this sleeve to shrink the 3-inch down to 2.5.
To give you a more secure fit.
Yes.
So this is one of the things that you can use it whether you're doing some towing conventionally or you start to do other towing experiments and things that you might want to do, you can utilize this to go ahead and make sure you're properly hooked up.
Yes.
And then what do we have here?
So this is our fifth wheel hitch.
Okay.
And for our fifth wheel hitch, we have two different ratings. We have the lower capacity and the high capacity. This is the lower capacity. But this is sitting on H-frame. So this H-frame is what you get when you order the fifth wheel gooseneck prep pack.
Now, I wouldn't normally see this, right? This is normally something that I wouldn't see, so we got to keep them in an exclusive, right?
Yeah, so this is normally under the bed.
Okay.
And so what you have is you have your connection points here, right? So your fifth wheel fits into this, and you already have the holes cut out in the bed for your vehicle. And if you were towing gooseneck, you would put the gooseneck ball here, and you would put the pucks here. And if you were buying the bigger ball kit with the 3-inch, it still goes here, it's a bigger ball, but you have a bracket, a bar that goes from these two spots. It's just a stronger connection.
Nice. Now I notice here the 19K, so this is rated for 19,000 pounds. Is that how that works?
It is.
Okay, gotcha. And you said this is the lower of the two, so there's one that even goes above that 19,000.
Right, so new for 23, we're coming out with a hitch that's rated to 35,000 pounds.
That's amazing. That's going to be great. All right, perfect. So this is great. And then, of course, as I mentioned, we have our gooseneck set up, which we're going to get into a little bit of how to properly set that up and make sure, because unlike the conventional, there's a few more steps that go into setting up the gooseneck, which we'll cover in just a moment. But one of the things that's nice, whether you're going conventional, fifth wheel, or gooseneck, it's making sure that you're properly load managing, right?
Yes.
And so we have some great tools in place and some technologies that really help make that easier. For example, like when it comes to payload weight, one of the things that we utilize is, of course, the onboard scale system, right?
Right.
And tell me a little bit more about the onboard scales and the importance of using that and why that would be beneficial when I get ready to tow.
So the benefit of that is you can go through and use the sensors around the vehicle, but you can load your vehicle up with weight. Mm-hmm. You can even put in estimated estimation for people weight or package weight if you don't have it while you're loading it. And it's going to give you a live number to make sure that you're not overloading the truck.
Wow, so it's going to give me a real-time predictive estimate of like, hey, this is what you have, especially like, let's say, for instance, you and I are going up, we've got our gear, we were loading up our trailer. We can go in and plug those numbers in to make sure that our payload management is exactly where we need it to be.
Right, right.
I love that. And then in addition to that, now we can also talk about weight distribution with our trailer, right?
Yes.
And that's utilizing the smart hitch feature.
The smart hitch, yeah. So with the smart hitch, it's helping you dial in so that you get it set up properly. So you have what we call Fowler, front axle load restoration, at the optimal number.
Gotcha. So that way to make sure that while you're driving or towing or hauling, that you're getting the optimal experience when it comes to that, because now you've taken that time to utilize some of those weight management systems to make sure you're as balanced and neutral as possible. I want to move on to setting up this gooseneck, and I'm going to ask you for your help, because while I have some experience in it, I want to walk through to make sure I'm getting everything set up properly for that.
Okay.
Now, one of the things that's nice about what we've done is we've kind of, like I said, gone ahead and hooked up some of the preliminary stuff. Now, keep in mind, when you're getting ready to utilize, whether it be the conventional, the fifth wheel, or the gooseneck, you want to follow all of the proper procedures to make sure that you have it properly connected and that you've taken the time to go ahead and get it in. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and get in my Super Duty, and here's the thing that I love, Bobby. Mm-hmm. I've got two new ways that I can get into the Super Duty, and they're standard. So how great is that? So one of the things that I can utilize, of course, is my rear bumper step, which is back here located in the rear bumper. Right. I think it's really great because it gives me that handle that I can grab into, but I'm actually gonna go ahead and use the front box step, which I think is another great way, instead of me using the tire, like we used to have to now I can go ahead and use that front box step, hop in the back, and then we're gonna go ahead and connect our gooseneck. Right. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Can you grab the pucks for me?
Sure.
All right, perfect. I'm gonna go ahead and use that front box step, and I'm gonna go ahead and hop in. I mean, it makes it super simple with me to go ahead and do that. All right. And I'm gonna go ahead and set my tablet down. All right, so let's walk through. I'll grab the pucks from you. Okay. Now, one of the things that you mentioned is that when we're setting up our pucks, we want to put these in the rear slots, right? Because we have four different spots that we can go ahead and connect to, but we're going to go and put them in the rear. Tell me why we want to do the rear in this particular setup.
So the reason why you would like to use the rear is it's going to give you the longest length of chain that you have to make sure that when you're turning corners, like you may have an extreme angle, that you're not going to catch one and pull on it when you don't want to.
Ah, that makes a lot of sense. So having it back here is gonna give me that added security that I need. Now I've already gone ahead and connected the first one. I'm gonna go ahead and make sure I've got this one in good here. All right, there we go. Okay. And I'm gonna check these to make sure they're secure. So good to go. All right. And then I'm also going to go ahead and connect my, tell me what this is again, Bobby.
So this is your trailer breakaway cable.
All right, perfect. Now, we're taking our trailer breakaway cable and we're running it to the front of the bed. Why are we doing that in particular?
Well, you want to make sure that you get it at the optimal length so that if you were to have an incident where the trailer separated from the truck, that you pull that cable soon after it breaks. You don't want to wait until you're all the way off of the bed before it pulls and stops the trailer.
Got it. So again, just another safety element to make sure, and I've got that secured into place. Now we can go ahead and connect our power, right?
Yes.
All right, perfect. So walk me through, we've got two cords here, so I'll have you walk me through each one of these.
Sure, so we have two. We have an accessory cable. It's a accessory cable and it has the red rings on it.
Okay.
And we have our 7-pin trailer light and brake cable.
Okay.
So we'll start with the accessory cable.
All right, I'll open this up for you.
So it goes into the bottom one. And so you see you have a red ring here, you have a red ring here. When it's fully seated, those red rings disappear.
Okay.
So now that one's gone. And when I clip in the bottom, it's gone.
Ah, okay. So basically, in essence, if I ever were connecting this and I was able to still see red, that would let me know that I don't have it properly secured.
Right.
And I need to go ahead and insert it all the way.
Right.
That makes sense.
Right. And so now you have the 7-pin lighting brake trailer cable.
All right. And I'll hold that up for you.
So when you insert this, you have a little tab here at the top.
Okay.
When it goes all the way in, it catches on the top here, and that way it keeps it from pulling out.
That
so
makes
when
sense.
It's all the way in, so if it goes in and this is sitting up and it's not down like it is now,
okay,
you know that it's not fully seated. But right now it's fully seated.
All right. So again, another indicator that just to make sure, hey, I've got it in, it's secure, and I'm ready to go. All right. So here's what I'm gonna do, Bobby. I'm gonna just double check and make sure I've got everything connected one last time before we hop inside.
Okay.
All right. So Bobby, it looks like I've got everything secure. We're gonna go ahead and hop inside the vehicle. But before we do that, guys, we've got a quick video that's gonna help you in getting your vehicle set up in your Ford Pass app. So check this video out, and Bobby and I will meet you back inside the vehicle. And so we're back. Welcome in, Bobby. Thank you for your help back there. All right, so I've gone ahead and set everything up. Now, before we get too far, I've got to tell everybody out there. So we did go ahead and put our safety belts on. Always best to follow the law of the land. But remember, we are in a closed studio. So I am going to turn the vehicle on in accessory mode, but we're not going to be doing any driving for this one. We had our fun doing our driving,
yes.
Right? All right, so here's the great thing, Bobby. So now that we've gotten in, I've turned the vehicle on in accessory mode, and boom, immediately it's already telling me me, hey, do you want to go ahead and add this new trailer?
Right.
Is that because we connected the 7-pin in the back?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
So the vehicle detected the trailer, and that's why the screen is here.
Nice. All right, so let's go ahead and follow the prompts and walk everybody through adding it in.
Okay.
So we're just going to go ahead and add a new trailer. And let's go ahead, we're going to name our trailer.
So now with this, you're going to add, you can create any name you want, but you have up to 20 characters for the name.
Okay, so any name I want. So I'm going to keep it simple. I'm going to call it Goose. How about that?
Okay.
All right, so go ahead and name that. All right, good. And then my trailer type. Oh, so it automatically pops up with conventional gooseneck fifth wheel.
Right.
Nice. Oh, well, obviously we know which one we're going with, all right? So gooseneck here. Mm-hmm. All right, go ahead and continue. I'll save this one. Now, the nice thing about it, I get to save up to 10 profiles, right?
Yes.
Nice. Okay, so this one is saved, so now I have 9 more left. All right, so walk me through this, Bobby. So it's got a default and an electric over hydraulic. Which one should I go with in this application?
So for this trailer, this is an electric brake trailer, right? But for the electric, it's listed under electric, surge, and none. So you would do it as default. Okay. If we had electric over hydraulic, then we would go with the second option. But for this, we want to use default.
Okay, perfect. So I'll go ahead and save that one. All right, and then what do you recommend for my trailer brake effort?
So based off the weight of this trailer, it's a new trailer, I would go with medium.
Okay.
If we were towing much, much heavier, or this was like an older trailer mm-hmm. or something like that, we may want to go to high, but for this, medium.
Medium, all right, sounds good. Perfect, and then, so this is part of what we did preliminary getting ready. I do have these notes in here so I can go ahead and plug these in. So the length that I have is 35 feet,
yes.
So I'll go ahead and change this. All right, there we go. And then my width is actually 8.5. Now, here's what I also enjoy. With my sync screen, I can either tap or I can go ahead and slide, which makes it really easy. So depending on which way I feel, I can tap or slide and get the data input the way I want. And then my height is 10. All right, good. Boom. And then my weight is actually 15,680. So let me go ahead and Okay, I'm not missing anything. Okay, so what do I do in this instance? So I've either got 15,500 mm-hmm. or 1,600 as my options. Now, what do you recommend based on the fact that we're at 15,680? So we're kind of sitting right in between the two.
Yeah, so I would suggest that we round up to 16, right? So the whole significance of this is that you want to make sure that your cover, because it's using this information to help route you for doing, if you're going to plan a navigation route from here to wherever you want it to go.
Okay.
And it's going to route you based off the information you put here. So because you want to make sure you're safe and that you don't cross any rate restrictions, you should always just round up.
That makes sense. I see the logic in that. So I've already got it to 1600, so we're good there. So I'll go ahead and press enter. All right, so now all of our data, we can double check it here. Everything looks accurate, so we'll go ahead and click confirm. All right, and Goose is now active, so we did it. All right, perfect. And check that out. So that brings me to my next. Now, I know Ann and Chelsea talked about the blind spot and BLIS, mm-hmm. but we have a new feature, an additional feature with the BLIS that's available when it comes to trailers such as like the gooseneck or fifth wheel. Is that right?
Right.
So tell me a little bit more about that.
So with the new accessory, it takes on from where the vehicle can't detect any further. So the vehicle is very good with doing conventional, is very good with doing any trailer shorter than 33 feet. If we have a trailer that's wider or a fifth wheel gooseneck or a longer trailer, we can add the BLIS sensors to the accessory port, the one with the red rings on it.
Okay.
And we add that to the trailer so we can detect those. So the reason why is that the trailer starts to get so wide, is wider than what the sensors can detect, and the trailer's blocking the sensors.
Got it.
So adding the accessory takes adding it to the side of the trailers. So now you're able to do it with those additional sensors.
And now having that additional input and having those sensors added, now it's going to give me extra peace of mind and security, because even though I have that wider, you know, kind of load behind mm-hmm. me, I'm still able to know that I can have my blind spots covered in spots that I can't see by myself.
Right.
I love that. That's great. Now, another feature that I really like to help with that and kind of widen out my view mm-hmm. is the power scope side mirrors.
Yes.
I think those are a game changer. Now, mm-hmm. the power scope side mirrors, I mean, just with the press of a button, I can go ahead and take these out and move these out very, very easily. And what I also like about them, not only are they do they power scope out, but I can go ahead and fold them in as well. So what's really nice is obviously if I'm parking or in a parking space or, you know, whatever the case might be, I can protect my side mirrors because, right. you know, that's important. Now, do I have to press this button every time that I get ready to put to fold the mirrors in?
No. So if you were parallel parking, because a lot of times with trucks and trailers are so long that they're not necessarily a space for them, and you may have to parallel park it on the street, you wouldn't want your mirror extended out where somebody can hit it. So the actually the super duty of the truck, when you shut it off, it folds the mirrors in for you. And okay. then when you unlock the doors, it will fold the mirrors back out for you.
Nice.
So that takes that out of the picture for you. Makes it where you don't have to think about it.
Yeah, just automatic. I love that. That's great. That's automatic. So another feature that I want to highlight as well is the available trailer brake controller. Now, mm-hmm. I'm familiar with the trailer brake controller that's located right here. Right. I've used that before. I'm familiar with it. But it looks the same, mm-hmm. but it sounds like it functions a little bit different. Is that right?
It does.
Okay, so tell me what's been updated.
So what's changed is we've always had it. It's always where you can still set it. The difference now is that I can save that setting in my trailer profile.
Nice. Okay.
And so now the difference from what we had before to now is each of my trailer profiles can have a different brake setting for each one. And what we had before was I had to always modify the brake setting when I go to tow next. So if I pick up another trailer, I have to go through and adjust it. With this, it's saved in the profile, so when I pull up the profile, it's already there.
That's great. And so, for instance, like in this one, we have Goose set up, and now we haven't adjusted it at all, but I'm gonna go ahead and just, because we're talking about it, mm-hmm. I think I'm gonna adjust it. I think 7 would be reasonable for this. So let me go ahead and turn it down, and now I have it set on 7, and so now my trailer brake gain for Goose is always going to be set up that way, and as I add more profiles, then I can, like you said, set it one time, mm-hmm. and it's always there when I go back to that trailer profile.
Yeah, you have in your owner's manual, right, it goes through and explains it, right, but you always want to make sure that you have it set up where you don't have the wheels on the trailer locking up, and you want the truck and trailer to stop together. You don't want the trailer stopping the vehicle.
That's great, yeah. And speaking of owner's manual, one of the things that I always encourage for you, everyone out there, is if you ever have a question of any of the information that you see on your screen, make sure you click this information button. Mm-hmm. It's a great resource and tool to really help you be familiar, because you might not be as fortunate as me and always have a Bobby that you can call and get help from. So utilize some of the tools and technologies that are available right inside your vehicle and hit that info button if you have questions. And of course, check your owner's manual, and in some cases, depending on your vehicle, your digital owner's manual, which is available as well. So that's awesome. All right, so another good thing and feature-wise, and you were telling me you were excited about this mm-hmm. one, and that is the turn signal view, right?
Yes.
That's a new feature for 2023 as well for Super Duty.
Yeah, so what this does is when you hook up a trailer, it is activated. There's an on switch in here in the settings to have it on automatically. But what it does is when I turn my turn signal on, I get the view of that camera on that side of the truck to make sure I'm clear, right? So I still want to use my mirrors, but it gives me the added benefit of having that here. And then I also have for my BLIS, my blind spot monitoring, I have an indication on the screen also when the space is open or when there's a vehicle there also.
Nice. So the same icon that I normally see for my blind spot detection on my side view mirror,
yes.
I'm also now going to be able to see in my sync screen. So just giving me one added layer of visibility. And really for somebody like me, it adds to that safety and security. When I'm behind the wheel, it boosts my confidence. Now I'm not gonna have to worry about it because I can see it here in my screen, or like you mentioned, still utilize my mirror and really just kind of use that as a double check scenario. So that's great. Now, we touched on Smart Hitch a little bit earlier, right? But one of the things that in researching and just kind of learning more about it, the load adjustment, I think that's something that I want to talk a little bit more about, of why that's important when it comes to that load adjustment when utilizing Smart Hitch, because I don't want that to get lost, because I know we touched on it earlier, but tell me a little bit more about why utilizing that load adjustment is important with that Smart Hitch feature.
So you're going through and you want to make sure that you put the proper loading, right? There's for each vehicle in the RV guide, there's a chart that tells you what your front axle load restoration should be set to. With the Smart Hitch, you can actually go through and it helps you figure out, as you're loading up the torsion bars, it's a live number, right? So as you're loading up, you're getting sense live data of where you are reference to that target.
Nice. Okay, so now it really just takes the guesswork out of it because I can have everything set up, and as you said, as I'm loading up, that load adjustment is going to make those adjustments for me, and I'm going to be able to see it real time with that live data. And now I don't have to question, I don't have to guess, I don't have to wonder. I can have it right there. Now, the other feature that we mentioned, and I don't want to get out of here before we talk about it, we talked about built-in navigation and utilizing some of the technology within the built-in navigation. Specifically, one of the things we alluded to was this feature right here, and that's trailer routing. This, I think, is a great feature when you're towing because what it does, it's going to basically optimize my route that I put in. So when I put in my final destination, it's going to optimize my route based on the trailer that I have connected, correct? Is that right?
Yeah, so it's going to take the four inputs that you put in, your length, your width, your height, and your weight, and it's going to give you a road GPS map based off of that input to make sure that you're not bypassing any restrictions.
So, I mean, because the last thing I want to do is be on a 9-foot bridge clearance with a 10-foot high trailer, right?
That's right.
So this is great because when I'm utilizing this, and again, for everyone out there, I want to emphasize, this is with the built-in navigation. So remember, this is not going to come up when you're using like Apple CarPlay or Android Auto. So you do want to go into your sync system, make sure you're utilizing your built-in navigation, and then take advantage of this feature because you can set up your trailer. As you can see here, we've got Goose set up, so it's good. And then when I put in whatever destination, it's going to help optimize that routing for me and get me where I need to go safely.
Right.
I love that. Looks like we've got a question coming in, Bobby. Let me check that. Give me 1 second here and let's see what our question is. Let's see here. All right, so this question comes from John. John, thanks for tuning in. Appreciate you. And so John's question is this, and we can maybe answer this one together. It says, when you're adding a trailer to the truck system and you have to add the weight, is the weight of the trailer by itself or trailer loaded?
So when you put in the weight, you should put the weight rating of what the trailer's rated for. If you want to put in the weight of the just what you're carrying, you can. But I would want to put in the what it's rated because if there is a restriction, I wouldn't want to get caught going down a road and I'm rated higher than what that road is rated for or what that bridge is rated for. If you got pulled over by a police, right, they may still give you a ticket, right? So I would want to go to what the trailer's rated for.
That's great. So, John, did you hear that? So, again, just as Bobby said, you should always enter the weight of the loaded trailer. So just to make sure. And if you have a constantly changing load, then you can request the system to prompt you so that you can enter the current load amount. So, John, I hope that answers your question. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for asking that question. That was a great question. So, all right. So let's see where we are now. So we talked about trailer rating and trailer routing, excuse me. So we've got all that covered. Now, we've done a lot of stuff to get hooked up in the studio before we got started, right?
Right.
You think we should give them a little bit of behind the scenes of what we did, how we got here?
Yes.
I think that's fair, right? Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. So we have a video that's gonna help you and show you how to line up your conventional trailer. So I want you guys to check out this video. Bobby and I had a chance to shoot it beforehand for you. So check this out and we'll be right back with you. We're already inside of our F-150 pickup, and we have a trailer that we want to get connected. Now, I've already gone ahead and made sure that everything behind us is clear, and I'm going to go ahead and temporarily disable my rear parking sensors. What do I need to do next?
So first, let's start putting the big one reverse.
Okay, I can handle that. All right.
First thing you're going to see here is the reverse camera view. So this allows you to help you line up your ball with the coupler. The trailer. As we get closer, we'll turn on the hitch ball view, which is a zoomed in view of just your hitch ball. The other thing you see here is you have your red, yellow, green is an indication of how close you are to an object.
And then what about this black line? Is this my line? Because I see it's coming off the trailer bar here.
Yeah, so essentially it's a line to indicate as you're turning the steering wheel, it changes, but it helps you line up a little bit better to tell you where your hitch ball will be with the steering angle that you have.
So I'm gonna utilize that along with my distance, and let's see if I can get this on the first try.
Just remember, as we're backing up, to remember you use your side view mirrors along with the rear camera view.
All right, let me focus in on this, and then when you're ready, you can go ahead and switch it over to that trailer hitch view for me.
So now that we're getting closer, I'm going to turn on your hitch view.
Okay.
You have two different ways of doing it. You can hit just the plus sign, and you can do it through the menu.
Oh, wow. Okay. Man, that's a big difference. So now with that, it definitely helps me in getting and making sure, because all I want to do now is just make sure the top of that ball disappears underneath my hitch. I think I'm there. How did I do, Bobby?
I think you're perfect.
All right, good. Now, one of the things that you told me is that when I get ready and I've got my hitch and everything aligned, you said that I should put it in park.
Right? Yes.
Put it in park. And then what was the second step?
You want to turn on your park brake.
Okay, that's right.
Right, so this is, you want to do this before you take your foot off the brake pedal because you want to keep the vehicle from shifting. You spend a lot of work aligning the tow ball up with the coupler. You don't want it to move out of place.
That makes sense. And so now I've done that. I have my park brake on. I put the vehicle in park. I'm going to go ahead and take my foot off the brake pedal. No shift. All right, so now all we got to do is hook up our trailer.
Yes.
You ready?
Ready.
Let's do it.
All right, so Bobby, I had a great time doing that. So just to recap for everyone out there, some of the technology that we utilized during that video, we utilized, of course, our rear view camera. We used the hitch view, which thank you for switching that over for me. And of course, we used our mirrors to help us line up the hitch ball to the trailer coupler. So just some of the technology that we utilized in that video. Now, there's some new features and some new technology that I'm excited to talk about, and I want to make sure we cover that as well. So one of the things that's big now is coming up is the Pro Trailer Hitch Assist, and that's new for 2023 and for the Super Duty in particular, right?
Right.
All right, so tell me a little bit more about that.
So with the Pro Trailer Hitch Assist, essentially what that allows is that you can press a button in the vehicle, and the vehicle will automatically back up the ball on the hitch to the coupler of the trailer. And the system will control the speed, it will control the steering, the braking, to make sure that it's right, I mean, you're right under the coupler.
Wait. So you're telling me that I can press a button and it's gonna do all of that work that I was sweating beads of sweat to do that you were teaching me, it's gonna do that for me.
It's gonna do that for you.
That's amazing. Now, here's the other great thing. Not only is that available for the Super Duty, but that's also available, gonna be coming up on the F-150, right?
It will, yes.
That's huge. Yeah. That is gonna be a game changer. Bobby, are you setting me up to be able to do all this towing by myself and me not call you for help anymore? Is that what's going on here?
Well, we want the customer, and we'll talk a little bit more about some of the other features, right? We want to try to get the customer where they can do all this by themselves. They don't necessarily have a second person there if they don't have it.
That's great. That makes sense. Okay. All right. So another one, and you were telling me again, another feature you're excited about, the tailgate down camera.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So tell me about why the tailgate down camera is really going to be a game changer, in my opinion.
Yeah. So essentially what we do is we have a camera on the tailgate, right? Not only the camera do we have sensors also. So in the past, whenever I drop my tailgate, I'm looking at the ground.
Yeah.
Now with this new camera there, when I drop the tailgate, it will switch over for me automatically. I'll still be able to look out the back of my truck to see where I'm going. So if I'm backing up to a trailer or backing up to a loading dock, I still now can see how close I am. And I have my sensors there to give me an indication as far as proximity to that hard point to make sure I don't damage my tailgate.
That is amazing. So now, just like you said, no longer am I looking at sand and gravel and dirt or wherever I'm driving. I can actually see where I'm going and utilize that. And like you said, with the sensor, it's going to know when that tailgate's down, accommodate for that distance, and that way I'm not hitting my tailgate unnecessarily.
Right.
That's huge. Now, another one that I like, and I'm gonna show them this too, because I want to utilize this technology, so I'm going to show off a little bit. All right, so for everyone out there, another great feature that I'm really excited about is the trailer light check. And I want to show you guys in your Ford Pass app. So if you haven't downloaded your Ford Pass app, I don't know what you're waiting for, but do it now. It's a great free resource and a great tool to be able to use. So let me show you what you're going to be able to see, because in your Ford Pass app, when you go into it and you're ready to do your trailer light check. Now this is important because it's part of your safety checklist. And so what you're going to do, now you're going to see my screen, it still has my F-150 there. But one of the things you're going to be able to do is when you go under vehicles and right here under features and settings. So what you'll see is in the features and settings, you scroll up and boom, you press that button and there it is, your trailer light check. And what's nice about this, it's gonna go through the sequence 5 times. So it will give you plenty of enough time to be able to check all of the lights that you have connected. So for instance, it's gonna go through your left turn signal, your right turn signal, brake lights, and if you have them equipped, then of course your reverse lights and your rear fog lamps. Now, so that's another great feature and just one additional reason why you wanna make sure you download the Ford Pass app. Now, Bobby, I know also if I don't have my phone or I don't wanna use my phone, I can also do my trailer light check from inside my cab, right?
Right, so we have it as part of the towing tile.
Okay.
Under there, so you can initiate it there. So the beauty of this is, if I'm outside and I'm working to hook up my trailer, my hands are all dirty, I don't worry about going inside, and I can do it right through my phone app.
Nice.
But if it makes sense for me to, I'm in the vehicle doing other stuff, and say I've hooked everything up and I want to do my light check, or I stop somewhere and just want to do it before I take off, I can initialize in the vehicle, walk in the back, see everything's working, hop back in, and I'm ready to go.
That's awesome. I think it makes it really simple to, like you said, give you the comfort and confidence where even if you don't have someone with you, you can still take care of a lot of those things that traditionally will require 2 people, because
right.
I don't know how I would press the brake and then run back to check if it's working. I'm fast, but I'm not that fast. So another feature, of course, is our trailer theft alert, right?
Yes.
So this is another big feature because it also is connected through the Ford Pass app, where it's gonna give you notifications if in the event there's a potential of trailer theft or something goes up. Explain to me a little bit how that technology works to pair with the Ford Pass app and give me that alert.
So the way this works is when you get out the vehicle and you lock your vehicle, It arms the system. If you have it on as part of your, in your settings, essentially what it's doing is monitoring the 7-pin connector that's connected to the trailer.
Okay.
And what it's just doing is looking for the trailer, and when you disconnect, it sees the trailer's not there, and then it will give you a notification on your Ford Pass, but it also will set off the vehicle alarm.
Nice. Okay, so basically, like you said, the main things I need to do is make sure that it's on.
Yes.
So go in my trailer towing menu and just make sure it's set up on. Make sure, of course, I have my Ford Pass app downloaded, my notifications turned on. And then, again, another layer of security. So if, let's say, I'm at a rest stop or maybe I've stopped for lunch or whatever the case might be, and if I get that notification, I'm immediately going to know that, hey, I need to go out and check my vehicle, my trailer. And of course, if I hear it, that's another indication as well. So
yes.
Lock it, walk away, make sure it's secure, and then I've got another layer of security there to keep me protected. That's great. So now we've gone through and we've showed them how to line up the trailer. We've talked about some of the technologies that they can use with checking the lights and getting all that stuff up. I think really the only thing left to do now is show you guys how to back your trailer up. Now, Bobby, you were great in helping me kind of get this down, but one of the things we're gonna do is we're gonna go to a video and show you some ways that you can go ahead and successfully back your trailer up utilizing some of the available technology that you're gonna find in your Built for a Tough truck. So check out this video. Now, we've gone ahead and already connected our trailer, and now I found a great spot to put it, and I wanna back it up and get it in place. So what do I need to do first?
So first I want to start off by going through some of the different camera views that we have. So I'm gonna hit the camera button to turn them on.
Okay.
It comes up in the 360 normal view. You have the front view of the vehicle. You have the 360 around the vehicle.
Yeah.
If I hit the menu, the zoom in button, I can zoom in anywhere on the 360 view.
Nice.
Of the vehicle. I hit the menu view. And next I can go to the normal front view.
Okay.
Next is the 180 front view. It's just an expanded view, a wider view of the front view.
Mm-hmm.
Next is the bed view. So I'm gonna come back to this one and talk about this a little bit more in a second.
Okay.
Next is the trailer, aux trailer view.
Okay.
So right now we don't have a trailer camera connected, but if we did, you will see the out of that view of that camera that's on the trailer.
So this is great because if I wanted to add an additional camera of my own, I can basically have that camera added and then have even more visibility behind my trailer.
Yes.
Man, that's huge. Okay.
Next, you have your hitch view.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a zoomed in view of the hitch.
Nice.
So you can see, make sure all your wiring, everything's connected, nothing came undone.
Okay.
And next is your general reverse view.
Okay.
So now, for the first 3 views,
yes,
they will actually change based off of what position you have the transmission in. If you put the vehicle in reverse.
All right, let me check this out.
Oh, I see it. It flipped. Okay. Yes.
So the 360 view shows you now for the left side of the screen, shows you what's out of the tailgate, out of the back of the vehicle.
Right, instead of the front. Okay, yes. Nice.
And then next is the general back view.
Okay.
And then next is the 180 back view of the vehicle, right? So it's just a wider view.
Right. All right, cool. Perfect. So you told me that you were going to go back to the bed view. So why was that? What's going on with the bed view? What do you have to tell me there?
So with the bed view, what's significant here is that this, as the name says, it gives you a view of what's in the bed of your truck, your payload.
Okay.
If you're driving down a road, you can actually look at this view while you're going forward in any forward or reverse direction.
Wow.
This view also is significant for when you're having a F-Series truck, like a Super Duty, mm-hmm. because now if you had a specialized hitch, a gooseneck or a fifth wheel, you can use this to help you line up the coupler of a gooseneck or the kingpin of a fifth wheel with your hitch that's in the vehicle.
That is incredible. All right, so now that we covered all of those, what do you think? Am I ready to go ahead and put my trailer in place?
Yes.
All right, cool. So what feature or what technology do I want to use next to help me put this thing in place?
So what you have next is your Pro Trailer Backup Assist.
Okay.
We've already gone through and played backup stickers on the trailer, and we've already calibrated the system so it knows that it's ready to use.
That's right. So for everybody out there at home, we went ahead and set up our trailer profile, which was great because it allowed us to go ahead and put in our measurements and all of our features. And so that way, I can go in and just go back to this trailer profile. Now that we've covered all of those, what should we do next?
So next, go ahead and put the vehicle in reverse.
All right, I can handle that.
And what we're going to focus on is this knob here. So this knob is going to allow us to adjust or turn their vehicle with a knob. So you don't have to go through the guesswork of which way do you need to turn the steering wheel to get the trailer to where you want. It's simple. Whatever way you turn the knob, that's where the trailer goes. So left is left, right is right. So what you want to do now is just take your foot off the brake.
Okay.
And use the knob to turn the trailer which way you want it to go.
All right, let's do it. Now, one of the other cool things that I love is that with this, we have a lot of different camera angles and views that I can mention. Now, one of those you told me about was that trailer reverse guidance, right?
Yes, and I'll bring that up for you.
Okay.
So with
this view,
you get your angle detect mode, right?
So, okay.
So with this, you have the black line, and mm-hmm. this tells you your relations of your truck and your trailer.
Okay.
And right now they're aligned because you're perfectly straight. But as you turn it, what you'll notice is this white line is going to differ from that black line.
Right.
And what the white line tells you, based off your steering input, so now you're starting to see it,
yeah.
how much the trailer is going to turn.
Okay. So this is going to help me to get to the spot that I want to be in. This is really going to allow me to get there and have that. And I see what you mean regarding the auto feature, where it's letting me kind of see and know exactly where I'm at.
Yeah, so that's the beauty of this TRG view with Pro Trailer Backup Assist. We'll talk a little bit more about it a little bit later, but what it does is it gives you an optimized view for this feature. It also is optimized for if you're using the steering wheel. And so with that is the view will shift over to give you the optimal view for backing up.
Nice.
With the steering knob, again, as you're turning the knob, it makes the trailer go where you want.
Mm-hmm.
If you let go of the knob, the knob will return to center, and your truck and trailer will straighten up for you.
That's it.
Yeah. So part of the trailer reverse guidance mode, there are tools. And mm-hmm. one of the tools that you have is the straight back mode.
Now, this is the system that you were telling me about, is that like I enjoyed using the knob, but for some people, they may want to do a combination of both, and they can use the knob or they can use the steering wheel, right?
Right.
Okay, so this is that feature that you mentioned to me earlier. Okay, so
now what you have is you have the steering wheel here, and then what this tells you is what you need to adjust the steering wheel in order to get the truck and trailer straight. So you see now you're a little bit turned to the right.
Right.
And it's telling you to turn your steering wheel to the right in order to straighten everything out.
Okay, got it. So now if I wanted to come back and straighten it out, I can utilize the steering wheel. And so just the same way that I was utilizing the knob, I can go ahead and use the steering wheel, and it's still gonna give me that same guidance to help me get to where I wanna be.
Right.
Okay, well, I knew I was in place, but let me do this. I wanna pull forward a little bit just so I can see how this would help me and lining up even more as I back up. So let's try that, and so I can see what the system is gonna do there for me. Okay, so this is great. So now this is telling me to go ahead and turn my steering wheel in this direction so that I can go ahead and go back straight.
Right. So it's also gonna give you a direction to try to make sure you straighten up your truck and your trailer so you're there, so that they're perfectly aligned. This mode is a tool to help you make sure you keep the truck and trailer straight as you're backing up.
Got it, okay. And so anytime I go off and I veer, if I'm not straight, it's gonna tell me, hey, you need to be in alignment. So this is where it's gonna help me to make sure I continue to be straight. So now I need to take my wheel back this way, now I'm back straight. And yeah. Now I'm back aligned and I can go straight back if I want to.
Yes.
Bobby, listen, that was incredible. Thank you for all of that information. I definitely am gonna be using that when I get out and about. But right now, we're here. So let's go head out and enjoy the rest of this day. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, so we're back. Bobby, that was fun.
Yes.
That was a lot of fun, very informative too. And I enjoyed being able to use a lot of the technology that we were able to employ in that video. So before we get into too much more, we did get a question that came in. This question comes from Wayne.
Okay.
So thank you, Wayne, for tuning in. We appreciate it. And Wayne's question is this. It's a good question. Mm-hmm. And I'll have you read it with me too, so you can see it as well. So it says, with the new F-150, the 2022, will the range select handle the high RPMs, or do I need to handle steep downhills another way when towing?
Okay. So in going downgrade, the easiest way is just leave the vehicle in tow haul. Tow haul is set up where it's gonna try to give you the most engine braking that it can.
Okay.
If you don't want and you wanna manually control it, you can go to the range select and manually downshift the vehicle to try to hold that gear as long as you want. So you have two options.
Okay, so Wayne, hopefully that answers your question. You can either, of course, utilize the tow haul drive mode, or of course you can go ahead and use the range select and then, you know, kind of do it yourself manually. So that's great. All right, perfect. Now, we can't not give them the recap of all of that technology that we utilize in that video. So let me give you the rundown of everything that we were able to use during our video. So we used the Pro Trailer Backup Assist.
Yes.
We also utilized Trailer Reverse Guidance, our 360-degree camera view, and we also used our bed camera view, which will really come in handy when I have certain things like our gooseneck or even our fifth wheel, which I think we touched on that when we were shooting our video.
Okay.
So now there's an additional camera view that we weren't able to show that's gonna be new, and I think that's gonna be really exciting as well. So tell us a little bit more about our new camera view that we have.
Yeah, so new for the Super Duty for 2023, we have the trailer 360 camera view. And so this is similar to the vehicle, except for now you're getting a 360 camera view around the trailer. So what this enables, again, for if you're by yourself and you're trying to back up your truck and trailer, you can look at that to make sure you're not getting too close to whatever's around the trailer. And then as you're backing up, you can zoom in on just one camera if you have something that you're getting really close to on the right camera. So this camera system, it comes as an accessory package that you can buy through Ford.
Nice.
It's four camera system that you have to install yourself around the trailer.
Okay.
But once you get it installed, you get it set up, you're good to go.
Good to go. So the same way that we utilize the 360 camera in our truck and we're able to go to specific zones or areas of the truck, I'll be able to now do that with my trailer, which again is gonna give me greater visibility. And to your point, like you mentioned, if for whatever reason you're screening my calls and I can't get a hold of you, I'll be able to go ahead and do it myself.
There's actually one other thing too with it. With this 360 camera view, you can actually add additional cameras. So like if you had something inside of the trailer that you want to look at, you can have it so you can see if your load shifted or something is out of place that you didn't expect. So yeah, you have that camera view, and it's a really good camera view to use when you're backing up your trailer.
That's great. All right, awesome. Bobby, we've covered a lot in this hour. So first again, Ann and Chelsea, they did a great job. They covered a lot. We've covered a lot. You know what I think I'm gonna do? This is now Towing Tuesday. That's it. I'm calling it. You heard it here first. Towing Tuesday. But no, seriously, let's give them a recap of everything we've covered in this hour. And we want to thank you guys, of course, for tuning in. But so far, we went through all the information that you need to know about your truck and your trailer before you get towing. We talked about how to hook your trailer up. We've also talked about how to add your trailer into the sync system. And then we talked about our some of our available technologies, such as our Pro Trailer Backup Assist and the one you just mentioned, which is the trailer 360-degree camera view, and so much more. There was so much more we covered. Bobby, I can't thank you enough for being here with us. I can't thank you guys enough out there for joining us and being with us. If you need more information or want things to know more about towing, you can easily go to Ford.com/towing. It's a great resource for all things towing and will really allow you to get more in-depth information for a lot of the things that we covered in our time today. And lastly, if you want more information on your specific Ford vehicle, well, for that, you can go to Ford.com/support. Listen, Bobby, again, thank you. Thank everyone out there for tuning in. We hope you had a great time and had fun. I know we had fun, but I looked at the clock and it's time for us to run. But don't worry, we'll see you on the next one.